Hey my loves, and welcome back to another budget stylist video. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a compare and contrast of the Hermes Oran sandals versus the Steve Madden Grease sandals. For those of you that follow me on Instagram, which is right up on the top right, my Instagram is at Lena Nori. You've seen that I have been constantly posting spring slash summer and also vacation outfit looks featuring these babies right here. I actually did a video on these sandals, or rather an unboxing, last summer. I think it was around September. And then I thought to myself, what better way to give you my complete thoughts on an item once I've unboxed it and used it for several months than finding the inspired version to kind of just give you a compare and contrast. Because a lot of times I'm doing these unboxings and just giving you my initial thoughts, but that thought sometimes changes, or my feelings towards the item as I'm wearing it over time. So now I have the Hermes Oran sandals, which I've worn generously, might I add, and the Steve Madden Grease sandals, which are the inspired version, AKA dupe. I guess they're also called dupes, but I like to use the word inspired. And this was actually completely random. I know that I just did another budget stylist video featuring the Steve Madden fanny pack versus the Gucci fanny pack. So this is completely a coincidence. I didn't intentionally pick Steve Madden again. I just happened to be at the Beverly Center walking by Steve Madden and I saw these in the window. But before I go into the compare and contrast, I wanna give you the details. Starting off first and foremost, which is the most important question, is what is the price difference? The Steve Madden Grease sandals are $79 without tax, where the Hermes Oran sandals are $680. You're talking about a $600 difference between these two sandals, not including tax, which is quite a difference. And there's so much you can do with $600, so that in itself is a huge reason why I give these Steve Madden Grease sandals a thumbs up. And so now that we know the price difference, I'm gonna go into my thoughts on these sandals now that I've been wearing them for about 8 or 9 months. They photograph amazingly. They look even better in photos than they do in person. I remember when I first got them, my thoughts were that they didn't fit very comfortably just even trying them on, but I was leaving to a trip and I knew that I wanted to take some awesome photos. Number two, I thought they had a really good resale value. They actually don't have a good resale value. I checked online and a lot of places like Poshmark and eBay are selling sandals in used condition for about $250 to $350. Now, these are still in better condition than a lot of the sandals that I saw for $250, but just imagine that that's already less than 50% of the value. So obviously it's not a great investment. I did think they would retain their value a lot better than they do. I'm actually quite shocked about that because Hermes, usually the belts and other items retain their value. I think it's mainly because they're easily accessible. They actually come in 12 different colors now. There's dual combo colors. They come in fuchsia, green. There's ones that are like white, black, and nude. So there's a mixture, and I think because there's so much availability, that's why you can get them for so much cheaper online. But going back into the sandals, they aren't the most comfortable sandals. I'll tell you that right now. If you're looking for comfort, these sandals are not those. When I first wore them, they were unbearable. I decided to take them on a trip, which was a terrible idea, where I was in Italy. We went to places like Positano on the Amalfi Coast, where everything is steps and pebbles, and I had blisters every single day, especially because it takes a little bit of time for this part to loosen up because this is a really thick and strong, sturdy leather. Hermes has always been known for their excellent quality leather. So when it's excellent quality, it's also gonna wear very well. So it took, I would say, 3 or 4 months for these to kind of expand. And yeah, I wish I'd actually taken these to the shoe repair and had them expand them for me. So just a quick disclaimer is that I do have wide toes. I definitely don't have narrow feet. So keep in mind that when I am giving you my thoughts on these shoes, that keep in mind that I do have wider feet. I also found that somewhere right in the center, it kind of feels like a little ball. It kind of dips lower and uncomfortable. But the problem with these sandals are they're definitely not meant to be worn if you are doing a lot of walking. And they also don't do well with getting wet. I know that they can get wet. They've gotten wet plenty of times. I just wore these when I was in Las Vegas to the pool. And anytime it gets wet, you kind of have that wet mark on the leather and it just doesn't look good for the several hours that it takes for it to dry. But other than that, this is excellent quality. The leather is impeccable and then it has this beautiful white stitching all around the H, which of course is short for Hermes. And that is their signature sandal or Oran sandal. They're not super bendable. As you can see, the only place that really bends is the toe bed. This part does not bend whatsoever, which is probably why it's not super comfortable to wear for long periods of time. And then it has a short little half an inch heel right here, which gives you a tad bit of height, But I love these sandals nonetheless. I'm gonna keep them because they're gonna sell for nothing if I were to sell them. So I'd rather just keep them and wear them. They look great with outfit looks. So if you are interested in these sandals, I will go ahead and link them below. But this is the color gold. Even though, as I said in my original unboxing video, these don't look gold at all. There's nothing about these sandals that looks gold. They kind of look like a darker camel brown, but they do photograph amazingly well. So now I'm gonna go into the Steve Madden Grease sandals, which I randomly found, as I'd mentioned, when I was walking by the store. And guess what? They're in rose gold. I'm actually obsessed with the rose gold. It's kind of like a foil leather. And what's interesting is they did have these exact sandals in the brown, and I wanted to get the brown just to give you guys a better example putting them side by side. But I thought to myself, if I get the brown, I'm likely never gonna wear those because I have these in brown. But I am obsessed with everything rose gold lately. Even my jewelry is rose gold. And it just goes so much better with like a summer sandal to kind of have like a little bit of a shimmer to it, especially if you are wearing this on vacation. And it will also photograph a lot better. And I haven't actually physically worn them out yet because I just got them. And just going into like my immediate review is that they're definitely a lot more comfortable. I've worn them up and down around the house, and they're just so much more comfortable, especially around the toe area. It kind of has like a soft material on the bottom, as you can see right there, so it doesn't brush up against the side of your toes, and it is a lot wider than what I was expecting, which is amazing because then you're less likely to get blisters on the side of your toes. And then the next thing I immediately noticed about these sandals is the bottom. It has a rubbery, rigid bottom, which means you're less likely to slip, especially if you are wearing these to the pool or somewhere where there is water. And that's the number one complaint, which I forgot to mention, that I have with the Hermes Oran sandals, is that in the beginning, especially until the bottoms kind of cut up a little bit, I found myself slipping a lot, especially if I was on like a smoother surface. And then secondly, I like the fact that I can wear these to the pool and not worry about them getting wet because they are a fraction of the cost of the Hermes Oran sandals. So overall, I'm really impressed with these sandals. I'm a little bit iffy about the fact that it does obviously look like an exact replica. And it's not that they own the specific look, but Steve Madden has an H on the sandal, which is the signature Hermes look, is their H. They have it on their belts, they have it on their click-clack bracelets, and then they also have it on their sandals. So they're definitely going straight for the look. And next, I'm gonna put them side by side just so you guys can compare and contrast what the sandals look like when you have them side by side. So these are the sandals side by side, and I'm just gonna go into the obvious differences. The toe shape is obviously a little bit different. The Hermes ones are a little bit more square, where the Steve Madden ones are more round. And then the next notable difference would be the insole of the shoe, or where you put your feet. And as you can see, the Steve Madden is more of a nude, which means it's more likely to also get dirty, especially if the bottom of your feet are dirty, where the Hermes ones start off with the original leather of the H color and then goes into more of a darker taupe leather. And all of the Steve Maddens, by the way, come with this nude bottom part. It's just the H changes color. So for example, there's a black, a white, I believe I saw a green, several different options when it comes to the look of the Steve Madden. And then the next difference would be the H. As you can see, the H on the Steve Madden, I would say, is about 0.25 larger than the Hermes H. And then the Hermes H has the stitching all around the H, where the Steve Madden one has no stitching. And then going into the rest of the sandal, I would say the Hermes one is like a tad bit higher. It's not really that noticeable of a difference. And then, as I'd mentioned before, the bottom, there is a difference in the fact that the Steve Madden kind of has the rubbery bottom, which you're able to wear and not slip as much. And the Hermes doesn't have that bottom, but as I've worn it a lot longer and there's cuts on the bottom, I find it easier to walk in. But in the beginning, they were definitely a lot slippier. And as I wore them over time and there's more cuts on the bottom, I find that it's not as slippery, but definitely in the beginning, it was really difficult to walk in them. And now that you've seen both sandals side by side, I'm gonna go into the last important topic, which is sizing. The Hermes Oran sandals are a size 38 and they fit perfectly. They did widen up over time, so they are a lot more comfortable than they were when I first started wearing them. But I'm actually usually a 39. And especially in other European sizes, I'm always a 39. I used to be a 38.5. That's because I wanted to always get a little bit tighter of a fit. And now I'm just not that girl that wants to walk around looking like a newborn baby lamb. So I go with a larger size, which fit a lot more comfortably, which are the 39. So these, I felt like you can go down a size. And then interestingly enough, the Steve Madden Grease Sandals, when I was first gonna order them online, I noticed that a lot of people were reviewing them and saying that they run small. I actually found the exact opposite to be true. These are a size 8 and I'm not a size 8. So I feel like I went down about a half a size. I'm usually a size 8.5 if I'm just in regular US sizes. And these fit perfectly. I also found that the toe beds were wide enough and not uncomfortable. And then also keep in mind too, if you want to purchase these Steve Madden Grease Sandals, they're only available at Steve Madden online, and then Macy's has them. I don't know if they're just signature to those two locations, but I will link all of those options for you below. And then of course, the Hermes Oran sandals can be found at the Hermes store, not online. You can see them online, but you can buy them in stores. And then eBay does have pre-loved versions of these, and so does Poshmark. Just make sure to do your research anytime you are buying a designer item online to make sure that it is authentic. And I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, don't forget to give it 2 thumbs up, and then of course subscribe below. And then don't forget to check out my Instagram account at Lena Nori, which is up on the top, because I have a ton of outfit looks with these sandals. So make sure to check it out, subscribe, follow me on Insta, and I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I will see you guys soon. Bye. To the moon, into the night.